This is where you train?
Oh gods, no. What a waste of me time. Just cheat using Zeus's lightning to enhance your muscles and stamina. That's what I do.
You're an inspiration.
I get that a lot.
What's this?
Not sure. Hades had it delivered. Deposit an offering for the ferryman, and unexpected help could very well arrive. Be careful, though. Argo broke the last gift from the underworld, and look what happened to him.
Who's Argo?
Exactly.
The gods get their dental exams?
No, it's where we rip off our skin to change our appearance.
Huh. Still better than visiting the dentist.
Those are a few ideas for ways to stick it to Typhon. You mortals seem to need an incentive, so I'll pay you Electrum for accomplishing each. And since I'm the god of merchandise, you can spend it right here on, you guessed it, merchandise.
Ooh, creative.
Or you could always just pay me your own Electrum.
I thought the incentive was for me.
I'm the god of financial gain.
Those prices! Wow!
I'm also the god of thieves. We all have our vices.
What's that underneath?
It's a chore chart. Someone has to get Ares to clean up after himself. Ever try to get blood out of a sea of blood? Now that is a feat.
Nice cauldron!
Fenyx let the empty compliment die in the ensuing silence, and instead tried to focus on potential potion recipes.
orange?
You're cute. Try not to impale yourself on anything.
But Fenyx wasn't listening. She was drawn to the forge by a hidden force. The aromantine she'd gathered, calling out to be reshaped.
There's that wonderful smell again.
Ambrosia is life. You want increased protection? Distill it here and drink up. Then enjoy the ride. One time, Athena downed that whole Kelix and destroyed the entire Greek fleet right after she had sided with them in battle. It was epic. Sorry. Guess you just had to be there.
Many of my relatives were. They died.
And I told Athena not to do that. But did she listen? No. Thank you.
Thank you.
Suddenly, the majestic form of a wild creature caught Fenyx's eye. If Fenyx wanted to tame the beautiful beast, the mortal would have to befriend it first.
Why are you whispering?
Because I don't want to scare it away.
What are you on? Because can I have some?
Ah! Thank you.
Neither God nor mortal nor beast is immune to Eros' charms. Aphrodite's son can make his chosen victim fall in love with the next person they lay eyes upon. All with just one click of his eye.
Sure, his arrow.
Please. Anyway. Not even Eros himself could resist
his arrow?
Thank you.
Remember when Aphrodite gave Psyche tasks to cipher out? The strangest one was having her sort an enormous pile of barley, chickpeas, lentils, beans...
Stop! You sorting through the whole list is just as bad!
think a pathetic army of demigods can stop me?
If you quit, I die. Remember that.
If there's one love story that always gets me, it's the story of Psyche and Eros.
Really? Yeah, come on. After finishing the trials and reuniting with Eros, who wouldn't grant Psyche immortality so they could be together forever?
That's sweet, Zeus. Shut up.
This takes me back. Psyche went to the underworld and met Persephone, who gave her Aphrodite's beauty ointment in a basket. All she had to do was give it to Aphrodite without peeking.
But Aphrodite knew curiosity would get the better of Psyche.
will make you perfect. You will suffer, but it will be worth it.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah.
Fenyx stumbled upon a winged creature. As Fenyx freed the small creature imprisoned on the isle, she let out a cry, which meant, "Great hero, I am but a piece of Nike, the goddess of victory. Please free the others, so I may return to my full glory."
They won't win without Nike. She's like a glove or a thing you wear that protects you while running. A helmet. So, what is it?
Fenyx would need to free it to find out.
Yeah, but you can tell me now.
Can you please respect my narrative pacing? The Valley of Eternal Spring. Its highlights include a massive tree that reaches up to the heavens. The Hall of the Gods. Eros's Palace.
Oh, I'm glad he finally got his happy ending.
And a palace belonging to the Goddess of Beauty herself.
Of course Aphrodite would claim the prime real estate with the best view. As long as she's safe from prying eyes, I'm happy.
From such great heights, a fluttering of birds, feeding from the most beautiful apple tree, caught Fenyx's eye.
Fenyx was about as high as I was when I thought marrying Aphrodite off to Hephaestus would stop the other gods from fighting over her.
Yes. That view from Mount Olympus is something else. I haven't seen it in years.
You're not getting that high again, so stop asking!
Tell me the deeds of golden Aphrodite, who subdues mortal men and birds in air, and the creatures on land and sea. Grant me a song. Stir up my sweetest passions.
Hey, watch it, buddy. That's my daughter-in-law you're talking about.
Didn't happen to be Aphrodite?
Why, yes, I am. Pleasure to humbly make your acquaintance.
Fenyx, sorry, I'm just such a fan. You're responsible for some of the most epic love stories of all time. I have to admit, I wasn't expecting a tree, but even in your, arboreal state, you're beautiful.
That's sweet of you to say, but the only mirror I gaze into these days reflects the happy smiles of the creatures I help. Oh, if only I could travel to those most in need. But alas, my roots keep me anchored here.
So that's why Typhon did this to you. So you can't use your beauty to move ships or inspire bravery in battle against him.
Me? Start a war? I don't know where you get such outlandish ideas. True beauty is found in acts of service. True love is the giving of yourself to others. The name Aphrodite should have stood for those things all along.
She did not just say that.
I am reformed now. My old essence locked away in a vault, wedged under my largest root, which is for the best.
Maybe I could get that essence back for you. I'm going to need allies to go up against Typhon.
We have the hungry to think about.
You said you need to free yourself from your roots. To feed the hungry, of course. Well, my roots were as a pretty bad farmer. So I know how to hurt plants. Salt. It shrivels them up.
Oh, would that work? But of course, my roots are not ordinary. They're primal. Powerful.
So we'll need, mythical salt water? Oh! Oh! This is in the prophecy! A pearl in rough seas! You were a pearl born from rough seas! The salty sea foam from your birth!
Yes! What an inspired proposal! But I couldn't possibly trouble a stranger to recreate the conditions of my birth.
What if a stranger asked to be troubled?
If a stranger asked to be troubled, then I suppose I wouldn't really be troubling them at all. Here's how to conjure sea foam from my birthplace.
I already know all about this. Mom loved this story. Grandpappy Uranus threw a pearl into the sea. The sea churned into foam, and Aphrodite rose up out of it.
A pearl? Grandpappy? I'm not sure that's how it...
That's definitely the story.
Okay. I'm sure that's how it went, down.
Got it. Knock a pearl into the ocean really hard. That sounds simple enough.
Oh, thank you, Fenyx. I'll be serving fresh apples to the less fortunate across the Golden Isle in no time.
Well, this is weirder than the time Demeter turned that kid into a lizard. Aphrodite, sweet and charitable. No more mischief.
Isn't that what you were aiming for when you married her off to Hephaestus against her will?
Hey now, it wasn't. I mean, she knew I was doing it for her own good.
Challenge me, Fane, and you shall be reduced to nothing.
We'll make our mark on the Golden Isle. Hopefully, they'll be able to fill it in later.
Yes.
Uranus locked all the Cyclopes away with the other Titans, huh?
Yes. He was afraid they'd overthrow him. There was a prophecy.
Bored. Grandpappy made the right call. Those things are an eyesore. Get it?
The birth of Aphrodite is a gruesome tale.
Nothing gruesome about it. Grandpappy Uranus and my deadbeat dad, Cronos, had a battle so great it severed heaven from earth.
That's not all that was severed. During his surprise attack, Cronos descended on Uranus.
When earth was severed from heaven, there was a great earthquake that knocked a pearl loose from its oyster.
Hang on, there was no...
The pearl flew from its oyster on land, and Uranus caught it and flung it out to sea with such a force that it caused the frothy foam to bubble.
Ha!
Thank you.
From the sea foam, Aphrodite rose, full grown, beautiful as that same pearl.
I can't take.
Tell me how it really happened.
And Kronos, they fought.
You can't be serious.
What? Fell into the sea.
That's...
because Kronos cut off his...
You're sick, Prometheus. Do not talk to me.
With the sea foam secured. Fenyx resolved to return to Aphrodite with the key to her freedom and the vault.
You've returned, you sweet creature. Do you have the sea foam?
Right here.
Oh. Aren't you good? Please, take my blessing for all your hard work. Now quick, pour the foam on my roots. The sooner I can move, the sooner I can expand my apple care.
Did it work?
Coming out of the foam, I was so fabulous. No! There's too many godly creatures that need my help. It keeps me awake at night, just seeing their little beaks and bright eyes. And those noses, those quivering, wet noses. I couldn't possibly imagine why. Whenever anyone defies him, he sends one of his wraiths. And that wraith delegates responsibility, as wraiths tend to do, to shades.
So the warrior that just appeared wasn't really Achilles?
Goodness, no! The true Achilles is far more dashing.
Oh, you're telling me.
He's hiding in a lair nearby until he's defeated. His shades will reappear on this part of the island.
Is there ever any good news?
Well, the sea foam worked and I'm able to move my roots. One of them was actually blocking Achilles' lair. I can't help but the other three raids, though. Heracles, Atalanta, and Odysseus. Oh, you know what they say. Bad things come in fours.
No one says that.
No one says that.
Tough crowd.
What about the root blocking your essence? It's just that some people I care about have been turned into stone. so I'm quite keen to...
Nope. No. For some reason, that root is still firmly in place. Thank you for your concern. But what matters is I can start delivering apples. All the animals will be fed in no time. Let's get to it. Thank you kindly for all your help. Many happy returns.
But I... That was strange.
I can't keep standing idly by. Sorry, I mean busily preparing anymore. You have to bring Aphrodite back to her beautiful, snarky self before I go crazy.
By the gods, where did you come from?
Behind you? Does it matter? Don't worry about me. Focus on finding another way to shrivel that root.
So what? Saltier, more mythical water? Actually, wait. What about Aphrodite's tears? Didn't she cry at the death of Adonis? They'd be salty and powerful.
You really know your stories, kid. Her tears just might work. If you put them directly on the root, blocking off her essence. Now, where did Typhon hide them? You should search the vaults of Tartarus nearby. There are three crystallized tears.
I think I found some already.
Please hurry. Until Aphrodite is back to herself, who will I talk to about whatever this is that you're wearing?
What's wrong with what I'm wearing? And he's gone.
Ha! Thank you.
Sure is quiet. That's not the worst, I guess. Hephaestus whining, Athena and Aphrodite bickering, Ares losing his cool. Why are we doing this again?
The smelliest of festivals, totally appropriate for Adonis. He didn't belong with Aphrodite, she was better than him.
Adonia was a celebration of women's self-expression. They would dance on the rooftops, bringing scented plants like fennel and cabbage to their parties. In the spirit of Adonia, isn't it Aphrodite's choice who she loves?
Not when it's rotten, like that smell.
And yet, the women of these villages let it waft from the rooftops, year after year. Maybe the freedom to make the choice is what matters. Fenyx would have to participate in the festival to open up to Adonia if the vault itself was to open.
That little turn of phrase and you light up like a pomegranate tree. Oh, I see you, Prometheus.
You have your pleasures, and I have mine. Still hear the screams of mortals fleeing while the Caledonian boar ravaged their country. Beside and destroyed all their harvests, all because King Onias forgot to make an offering to Artemis. Do you know why roses are red?
I'm about to find out.
When the boar mortally wounded Adonis, Aphrodite cried over his body in a meadow filled with flowers. Her tears mixed with Adonis's blood and painted the flowers red.
Do you know why violets are blue? The flowers held their breath waiting for you to finish one of your stories.
Would have been wise not to spend so much time with Aphrodite. She had many jealous lovers.
Yeah, well, she wasn't in love with his brains.
He couldn't best the boar sent by jealous Ares. But when a sad Aphrodite poured nectar over Adonis's wounds, out sprang the gorgeous anemone flower, a symbol of new life.
Huh.